Hey guys, Blazing Wrath here, and today I'm going to give my honest feedback and thoughts of Halo Infinite. I'm going to try and pinpoint issues and praise about the flight I got invited to, which once again, big thanks for the invite, 343. Overall, I enjoyed my time with the flight, and I can confidently say we got a good game coming out this year. And with that being said, let's begin. First off, let's talk about the music. Overall, the music in the game is really good. Even after finishing the flight, like I still like hear the music playing in my head over and over again. It's just, I mean, nothing more to say other than just outstanding. And it's great to hear the classic Halo 1 theme that plays, but that one is rare. But if you do get it, oh my goodness, nostalgia hits. But yeah, overall the music is like an 11 out of 10. It's really good. Next thing I want to talk about is the UI and all the things in the main menu screen. Overall, aside from general bugs, it's fine. Some feedback I could give is that I think it'd be nice if I could see my credits and XP boosters in the main menu, just like Call of Duty Modern Warfare. Because in that game, when you're in the multiplayer menu, you can see your boosters, whether they're active or not, at the bottom of the multiplayer screen. I would also like to see an increase in responsiveness when switching between the play, customization, and shop area. Particularly the customization menu, because the background took very long to load up, and the UI and the customization menus are very buggy itself. Though I'm pretty sure you guys are aware of that already. Next up is customization. Overall, it looks pretty good. But one thing I have to say is there better be more armor coatings than what was in this first flight, because that's definitely not enough. I know this is just a tech test, and not everything may not be here, but I'm still going to mention it nonetheless. We need more basic armor coatings at launch. Some examples I can give is maybe, like, for example, red. Maybe give us a red and white, or a red and black, you know, and vice versa. Maybe like a black and red, a white and red, you know. Variants of the colors that you've given us. Because I've already seen, like, when going into games, I've already seen, like, people with the same armor coatings, and a little distracting to me personally is just like, hey, that's my armor coating, you know, something like that. A couple of nitpicks for me while we're on the topic of customization is when adding a prosthetic hand, the armor piece on your hand is gone. While in Reach, when you put on the robot arm in Reach, the armor piece stays. It's just a small little nitpick. Like when you switch to the robot arm in Reach, the armor piece on top of your hand and your shoulder piece stays. But it's just a small little nitpick. I just like to see the little armor piece on your hand return, especially since now we can customize our gloves, so. Yeah, just a small little nitpick from me. Also, I know you guys mentioned this on Twitter, but please let us cross like certain armor pieces with different armor cores. Maybe you can let us try that in the next flight. Like, I want to use Emile's helmet, but I don't want to use the Mark 5B just to use Emile's helmet, you know? Because I want to use Emile's helmet with the Mark 7 armor core, because I really like the Mark 7 armor core. I think it looks really cool. Another thing I like to say in the customization menu is I think it's cool that we now have AIs, but I'd also like the option to actually completely remove the AI. Like, what if I don't want an AI, you know? Because, you know, some people, I've seen people say, like, they don't need someone holding their hand or, like, you know, anything like that. But just food for thought. So that's my take on the customization. Overall, you know, I like it. Next, let's talk about settings. Overall, there are plenty of gameplay settings and to customize, and it's overall pretty good. Nothing bad to say with the exception of a few things. The step jump, aim assist on mouse and keyboard, and apparently you can like change your bloom or like adjust your reticle size or something like that. Not sure how I feel about those settings because they can impact gameplay in maybe a negative or unintentional way. I don't know, maybe other people in the community could explain that better. But just thought I'd mention those, you know, particular settings. Next, let's talk about gameplay. Now, for the most part, the core gameplay is very solid, and 343 might have solved the sprint debate that the Halo community has had over the years. Now, I don't want to go into too much detail into the movement topic too much, because I want to make probably a separate video talking about, you know, the sprint, slide, clamber, and maybe even the maps. So I don't want to dive into it too much. Just so you know, the core gameplay is tight as fuck. Now, I also like that there's very little aim assist and very little shot magnetism. I've never had a feeling of my shots curving to my opponents, or if I miss a shot, I'm going to know that I missed a shot, and I really like that. So try and keep that. That's really good, 343. Next, let's talk about the HUD. So, about the new HUD change, which Halo hasn't really, changed its HUD for years since 2007 with Halo 3. Now, I know why they changed it the way it did, the way it is, but I gotta say, I still prefer the old HUD we've been playing with for years. My first problem is that all the shit that's at the bottom right of the screen is too small. Granted, I could probably change the size myself in the settings, but I'm going to mention it anyways. But my second problem is that sometimes I get confused which grenades I have selected because, again, the little rectangle at the bottom of the grenade slot is too small. On top of that, I would have to get used to the new grenade swapping feature, where now we can only carry two grenade types, which I really like that feature, by the way. It follows the same logic with holding two weapons. I have a similar problem with the equipment slot because, once again, it's too small, and I even forget sometimes that I even have any equipment. There were times where I went to pick up an OS or a camo, and I was like, why wasn't I picking it up? And then I was like, oh, I have a drop wall in my inventory, and I forgot I even had it. So I had to swap out the drop wall to pick up the OS, and then I had to pick back up the drop wall. The weapon slot and ammo is the only thing I didn't have an issue with. Shields were also a non-issue, though a small nitpick for me is that the sound when you're close to running out of shields is different, and I prefer the old one, but that's no big deal. The radar, however, I'm gonna hold judgment on because when PvP was active, things changed compared to when fighting against bots. Overall, I'd really like the classic HUD option when the game releases because in previous games, when you pick up an equipment or an armor ability, it was obvious where to find them. I don't know, things worked fine with the HUD we've had for years. 343, can you please just give us the classic HUD back as an option? Kate, thanks. Next thing I want to talk about is Jeff Stitzer and the medals. So, Jeff Stitzer is awesome. I really like his voice in the game, and I really feel like 343 finally nailed a balance between, their Jeff and Bungie's Jeff. Oh, and my only nitpicks are really that I've noticed that the Killjoy medal is back, but Jeff doesn't say Killjoy, because in Halo 3 and Reach, he says Killjoy, so I'd like to hear him say that again. It's been so long since I've heard him say it, and Killjoy was completely absent from Halo 5. Even Halo 4 had it. Lastly, the medals themselves need to be bigger. The colors need to be more recognizable to how they were back in Halo 3 and Reach. I've noticed some have been reverted back to like Halo 2, and like I think that's really cool. But the point is to make them bigger and revert them back to classic colors. Because whenever I think about medals, I always think about how they look in Halo 3 and Halo Reach. I don't even remember how they look in Halo Infinite or 4 and 5. I always think of like what? Halo 4 and 5, they were all blue, and I think what, Infinite, they're all red or something. So yeah, I like the classic colors. They worked, and they're always the ones I look back on. I do like the new medals that were made. Like I heard, they changed the new Reaper medal or something, or like Demon for the 40 kill mark or something. That's really cool. Even the hidden ones like 360 and Bank Shot. Those are cool. Those are nice additions. But yeah, that's my take on the medals and Jeff. All right, let's keep it going. Next, let's talk about bots. Overall, they're pretty solid, though they definitely need some work and refinement. Because on live fire, in the beginning of matches, bots keep going to the left in the open field, and on recharge, bots keep consistently going at the bottom mid. And I also had a bot kill himself on Spartan difficulty on Bazaar. So, I even saw a bot struggle to clamber multiple times on recharge. So they definitely need some work and refinement. Also, one more thing I want to say about the bots is please tone down their grenade throwing accuracy and grenade spam. It's very inhuman-like. Oh, and maybe I'd like to see a new difficulty for bots called Demon, where they literally attempt to mimic pro players and they're just absolutely insane. Just food for thought. But anyways, that's really that's my th those are my thoughts on the bots. Next, let's talk about the friend or foe system. First off, the settings in the settings section, there is an option where you can change whether you want to see your teammates' gamer tags or service tags, but this only applies for custom games. So I didn't know who my friends were or where they were exactly during matches. So please make that option apply to the whole game and not just custom games. That would really help a lot. As far as the red outlines go on opponents, I never really had a problem with it. Only in the very beginning, but over time I got used to, who my teammates were and who my opponents were, so overall it's fine, I guess. One thing I can say is that kept throwing me off is the shield colors are the exact same as the outlines. The problem with this is that it makes it very difficult most of the time to see how much shields my opponents have. I think a simple solution would be to bring back the yellow shields again. That way, maybe I can better determine the shield strength of my opponents. Lastly, remember how I said the red outlines on my opponents didn't really bother me? Well, when 343 turned PvP on for 2 hours, I feel that it now started to matter because there were a couple instances where I was looking around and one guy came out of a doorway and the red outline caught my attention. Or even vice versa. I had no shields and I was trying to hide and recover my shields and I died. And I can't help but wonder if my opponent saw me because of the outline or my shield deflects gave me away. So just some food for thought there. Personally, if I may make a suggestion, maybe have my teammates keep the blue outlines, but also have the arrow and their name just like, previous games. And then for my opponents, maybe don't have anything, literally just a red name and the red reticle. So maybe that's how I would personally do it. I don't know if maybe you can add that in the options section, but that's my take on that. Overall, the when PvP was turned on, the entire meta of the game changed. Next, a brief take on the weapon sandbox and maps. Overall, it was pretty solid. However, once again, when 343 activated PvP for 2 hours, the gameplay meta changed. So probably what I'm saying now, or what I could say in a future video where I will go more in depth in the weapon sandbox, it could change. When PvP was active, I really found I found myself sprinting a lot less. I'm sure a lot of people weren't used to the Halo 5 HCS ability tracker, and it probably threw a lot of people off. But of course, I knew. Anyways, like I said, I will make a more in-depth video going into the sandbox and equipment. But yeah. And that brings us to the end of the video. Overall, the game is solid, and I can't wait to play the next flight and provide feedback again. It was a lot of fun, and also a bitch to play because of technical issues. But hey, that's why it's a technical test. But anyways, please, if you like what I had to say, if you agreed or disagreed with the things I said, I want to know. Post them down in the comments down below. This is an important time to provide feedback and start up discussions. If you enjoyed what I had to say in the video, please share this around. And lastly, 343, I hope what I said was constructive and hopefully you guys were able to get something out of this video. And with that being said, until next time, peace.